Hello everyone. So in this video we are going to see the flowchart procedure for Euler's method. So what are the important steps in the flowchart that we are going to see? So here is the symbol for starting STA. So this is start of the flowchart. Okay, next we have to define the function. So define dy by dx, so which is a function of f x y. Okay, dy by dx, which is a function of x and y. So this means that define given function as dy by dx equal to f dash of x. Okay, so define as a given function as dy by dx, which is a function of x. For example, so dy by dx, it is a function of minus x y square. So this is one of the example. Next, after that you have to read the values. Okay, so input values which is given in this, read x0 value, y0, h and xg. Next step is to read x0, y0, h and xz. So it means that you have to enter the initial values of x0 or xy as a x0 and y0. And next, this h is nothing but the step size and the value of xg for which yg is to be found out. Okay, so value of xg is given, for which you have to find out yg at the value of xg. So x0 and y0 are the initial values, x and y. H is nothing but the step size and xg, the value is given of x. For that you have to find out the value of y. Okay, so next step is find out n, which is equal to x0 minus xg minus x0 divided by h. So what is this n? N is to calculate the required number of the iteration. So n is nothing but to calculate the required number of iteration as n is equal to xg minus x0 divided by h. So h is given, that is step size, xg the value is given and x0 is also given. So you can find out the value of n. So next step is you have to use the for loop. So for I equal to 1 is to n. Okay, if so from I 1 to n, so value of n is here, you can find out. So 1 to n, here if s, then yg, which is equal to y0 plus h into f of x0 y0. Next find out x0, which is equal to x0 plus h and y0, which is equal to yg. If yes, you have to follow these steps. If no, then directly go to this step. Okay, so if it is not satisfied, again the steps is repeated. Okay, so for, it means for first iteration, that is I equal to 1, you have to calculate the value of yg as y0 plus h into x0 y0, and for next iteration increasing the value of x0 by step size x0 plus h and replace y0 by yg. Now this process is continued for n number of iteration. So first iteration, second iteration, third iteration, n number of iterations is going to perform, and at last you have to print the value yg. The value of yg is to be printed out, and the program or the flowchart will be end. Then the flowchart will be end. So these are the important steps for Euler's method. From start, then you have to define the function dy by dx f dash of x. Next you have to read the values x0, y0, h, xg. Next find out the value of n, which is the number of iterations. Sometime h is given, sometime n is given, you have to find out h. Okay, next, so number of iteration is to be performed. For that you have to use for loop. I, for the command is I equal to 1 is to n. So first of all find out the yg, which is y0 plus h into a function of x0 y0, then x0 equal to x0 plus h, and y0 equal to yg. Okay, so number of steps will be followed, and at last we have to print the value of yg. Okay, and then this flowchart will be end. So I hope you understood this Euler's method flowchart. Thank you. Thanks for watching.